Since December, since the COVID-19 vaccine was first introduced in America, we've watched the age eligibility just drop from those most vulnerable, the elderly, to 65 and older, and then it went down incrementally from there to now where anyone over the age of 12 can get a Pfizer COVID shot if they want one. But that still leaves a large portion of Idaho's population that isn't eligible. And that also has led to a lot of questions about that younger age group. Like, without a vaccine available, are we seeing more cases in those under 12? And what about hospitalizations? Are those numbers up too? Joe Parris spoke with Idaho health experts today about the data and what the situation looks like right now in the Gem State.
Thousands of Idahoans are now at least partially vaccinated. Close to 50% of Idahoans 18 and over have had at least one dose. Public health experts say they wish vaccination rates were higher, but they are optimistic about those numbers continuing to increase. One area of concern across the country is COVID rates among children under 12 who can't get the vaccine yet.
Certainly, there are some other states that either have reported that or are reporting it now.
Dr. David Pate is the retired CEO of the St. Luke's Health System and a member of the governor's COVID task force. He says Idaho is not a place currently seeing an issue with adolescent COVID cases. Pate says some recent good news came back in May when Pfizer got emergency clearance for use of their vaccine in a new age group, 12 to 16. About 13% of those aged 12 to 15 in Idaho have had at least one vaccine dose, and 24% of those 16 to 17 years old. Still, though, there's no vaccine for Idahoans younger than 12, leading to questions about COVID infections with kids. Experts point out their body will likely handle the virus okay, but there is another issue to keep in mind.
It is certainly unusual for a child to become very ill. But the concern is those children taking the virus home to their parents who may be more middle-aged and may have some underlying medical conditions and may not be vaccinated because they're thinking, oh, well, you know, I'm not high risk. I don't need to get vaccinated. But now the child is bringing the virus home.
So what do the infection numbers look like for younger Idahoans unable to get a vaccine? This graph shows cases among 0 to 4-year-olds since early last year. You can see the cases spike towards the end of 2020, but begin to decrease steadily through this year. The Department of Health and Welfare reports the incident rates for 0 to 4-year-olds over the last few weeks is about 16.5 cases per 100,000 population. The infection rate has plateaued in recent weeks in that age range. It's a very similar story for Idahoans age 5 through 12. Cases are at about 19 per 100,000 population, with a mostly downward trend over the last 10 weeks. With that said, Health and Welfare reports despite no vaccine ready yet, they are not seeing an increase in COVID cases for those younger than 12.
Generally, I mean, it's been looking pretty favorable in Idaho.
Dr. Laura McGeorge is with St. Luke's Health System. She is the service line medical director for primary and specialty care. She says it's very important for those recently eligible teens and tweens to get a vaccine.
For a child or adolescent, the risk of hospitalization from COVID-19 is more than double the risk of hospitalization from influenza. So again, most kids are going to have a very mild case if they have symptoms at all. But again, we don't want them to spread it to other people that may be at more risk.
One demographic of concern is Idaho teenagers. Cases among teens 13 to 17 years old have shown a downward trend of cases in recent weeks. But still, teenagers have a higher incidence rate than younger kids at 37 per 100,000 population. It's important to note many in this age group only became eligible to get a vaccine about a month ago. But experts say it's important to get that group vaccinated to help cut down on community transmission and to help push towards a more normal school year beginning in the fall.
Before you know it, we'll be getting back into the mode of back to school. And so definitely don't procrastinate getting the kids vaccinated.
Everybody wants to get back towards normal in school. This is our way to do it. Let's get vaccinated so we can have a more normal school year next year.
Okay, Joe, COVID cases among kids, that's one thing. But what we've been talking about from the beginning of this pandemic, hospitalizations, where the hospitals can, handle this, but hospitalization, if you're sick enough to go to the hospital, that's a big deal. What's that look like for kids in Idaho?
It's actually really been the same over the last several weeks and months. Really towards the end of last year, beginning of this year, we did see more under the age of 18 hospitalized. You know, one thing that people follow is those MIS-C cases. That's a syndrome that was really prevalent among younger people that were infected with COVID. Now, the state of Idaho has seen 26 of those throughout this entire pandemic, and that's pretty close to what we've seen in Oregon and Washington. But if you look across the country, really back east and in the southern part of our country, they're seeing more and more of those MIS-C cases. So for now, Idaho looks like it's actually doing pretty well, but there is concern that as variants move across from east to west, there could be more issues going forward. Now, there's also been questions, Brian, about the case counts among adolescents.
I was going to ask you about that. The graph that you showed, it showed those numbers going down, but can we believe those are accurate?
There's reason to believe that there's being underreported, but there's nothing malicious behind that. I mean, point and simple, if you have a 5 or 6 year old that's home, that's a little sniffly, or maybe they may have allergies, you're not sure, you're likely not going to bring them in for a very invasive COVID test with the big thing up the nose and the whole thing. A lot of parents have just been keeping their kids home. So is it underreported? That's one way to look at it, but it's also the practical sense that they just may not be being reported. If one family member gets it, gets COVID, you assume the others have it, doesn't mean everybody went in. Again, nothing malicious, but those numbers that we're seeing are likely lower than what's actually in the community. Important to remember, the virus is still out there. Yep. If you're not vaccinated, experts say you got to mask up and you got to keep going with those great health hygiene that we've worked on over the last 18 months.
And what you said with these numbers going down, people maybe just assume if they one person has it, the others might get it. Why put a child through that kind of invasive procedure? All right, thank you, Joe.